Okay, my name is Cyrus Nabati. Today is July 28th, 2021. I just went through a heart surgery. My heart was operated on by Dr. Trento back in January 2009. And he put in an aortic valve and a mitral valve that are mechanical. And he said that it will last up to 30 years, much longer than an organic valve. I have not been feeling well for the past year and a half to 2 years. I do have a pacemaker as well. I had acute rheumatic fever when I was 16, and it led to other things regarding my heart. So I had an open heart surgery back in when I was 20 years old. I'm 62 now. I was back in Cedars-Sinai, and Dr. Trento and another doctor had to do two surgeries. One was to replace one of the valves, which was the aortic. I heard from another doctor that, another cardiologist, he said that it may not be the right size and it's not functioning properly. But the major thing was the tricuspid valve, and there was a leakage there, and I didn't have that leakage before until about a year and a half ago, where I went to see my regular cardiologist, Dr. Azmoun in Rancho Cucamonga. And prior to that, I was not feeling well, so I called him and I saw him and I told him, I'm not feeling well. My skin is changing color. I'm retaining a lot of water. So he changed my medication. He changed the medication completely, and this continued until I had internal bleeding, and I was admitted to San Antonio Regional Hospital in Upland, California. And over there, they looked at everything. My INR, which shows how high my blood, how much my blood is thin, it was supposed to be between 2.5 and 3.5. So they took me off of that. Actually, I took me off of that the night before, because that's the procedure. And it kept going up to close to 8. That's what I was told. That means you can bleed really doing anything. And they could have given me vitamin K shots and this and that for it to come down quick, but nobody did anything. And they didn't and couldn't do anything about my stomach, because they said one of the cardiologists, which I will provide the name, he told me that everything I'm going through is because of my valve that putting water back into my system. And he asked me if he could do a TEE T-test to really show him. And he said, look, normally this has to come out of your tricuspid valve, and the speed should be 1.5 per minute, but yours is over 4.5, and it's really severe, and most of what you're going through is because of that. My own cardiologist didn't want to have anything to do with my case, who is Dr. Azmoun. He changed my medication. Before that, he played with the dosages of my old medication, and he could not realize or find out that there was a different problem. But another doctor, another cardiologist, right away, he said this could be the problem. So they didn't want to do anything about my stomach because my INR was too high, my blood was too watery, and they didn't dare do anything there. So they contacted, and that was by my request, they contacted Cedar Sinai because they said you have a valve issue, heart issue that needs to be addressed first before anything else. So I waited 2-3 days in the hospital. You know, the departments are not talking to the right people. Everything that could have happened immediately took 3 to 4 days to happen. Anyways, I finally ended up there. Dr. Trent, who finds out I'm there, comes to see me and he says, look, let me talk to one of my colleagues or a group of colleagues, and then I will let you know the day after tomorrow what we decide to do with you. What I know, I think it was the next day, and I was surprised because he didn't come back to talk to me. Or maybe he did and I was asleep, I don't know, but I didn't see him until I realized that they are prepping me for surgery. In that surgery, he replaced the valve that was supposed to be good, Dr. Trento. The valve that was supposed to be good for 30 years because he said there was some growth around it. And I think another doctor, which I never met, tried to do something with my tricuspid valve. And at first they thought it was okay, but a few days later they found out that I had a stroke while I was on there because the surgery was supposed to take an hour and a half and it took about over five hours. So I suffered a mini stroke as a result of that and being in hospital for 2 months just to recover. And 2 weeks of that was in a rehab center, which was the wrong rehab. They sent me to a wrong rehab. Another doctor told me they should have sent you over here. But anyways, my recovery before they let me go was about 2 months, a little over 2 months. I have a lot of problems. I have double vision. So I cannot, I really feel like I've become disabled. My body, my feet, even when I was in the hospital, and I don't know why they let me go because they didn't fix the problem. I had no problem before. They caused problems and they let me go like this, and now I'm home. I don't have Medi-Cal and I don't want Medi-Cal. I have a notch above that, which is Blue Shield of California, PPO. That's what I qualify for. And it allows me to go to any doctor, any hospital, thank God. I don't wanna change that because I wanna deal with the same doctors because they know what they did. All these problems started about a year and a half to 2 years ago when I went to my regular cardiologist, Dr. Osmond, in Rancho Cucamonga, California. And I had a pacemaker test. The technician went and spoke to the doctor. This is after me complaining to the doctor. I was never feeling good. I was okay for a couple of years, but I have been under his care for probably 6 years now. They believe that one of the leads from my pacemaker is not working properly, and also, and this is in March of 2019, about 2 years ago. That was in March of 2020 or 19, probably 20. He said that I needed to have a different pacemaker, one that is also a fibrillator because they saw an episode of tachycardia rhythm 2 months earlier while I was asleep. And he said, that's very dangerous and is very threatening to your life. And before I know it, he said, look, I made an appointment with the hospital. This is San Antonio Regional Hospital. And we can do this on Friday. I have to do an angio first. He did an angio. And they were checking on it because they were worried about hematoma. Next day, some other doctor that he said is the best in this area, I never met him, Dr. Merla, he came and he saw me connected to heparin. They had taken me off Coumadin. I was on heparin, and my understanding is that heparin should be stopped at least 5-6 hours before another surgery so that you don't bleed to death. And it was surprising to that doctor, it was surprising to me, because I've learned a little bit about different medications, when they use it, and for what reason. But he went ahead and he did a surgery. I had a bad case of hematoma. I have pictures that I took of myself for 6 to 8 months. And after that, I never felt the same way. And I kept calling my doctor, the cardiologist, Dr. Osmo, that look, but the hematoma is almost gone, but my skin is changing color. I don't feel good. I get bloated. Even if I drink water, something is wrong. Something is wrong. This is when it all started. And so the rest I've already explained. He changed the dosage of my medication later on. He changed the medication, but he failed to recognize the fact that the problem is from my heart, and he's a heart doctor. I hate to say this about him because I like him, you know, he's treated me for 6 years, but it's changed my life so drastically. I can't even see one, because I suffered a stroke while they were operating in my heart. And instead of hour and a half, my operation took over 5 hours. So they kept giving me anesthesia. And I believe that's the cause of my stroke. And it's made me kind of disabled, because I cannot drive a car. I have to depend on other people for everything. I'm stuck. My insurance doesn't cover everything because it's not Medi-Cal, and I don't want Medi-Cal, because in the middle of everything it's gonna create a lot of things, and I'm gonna lose my doctors because they will not accept Medi-Cal. So this is my story. I'm gonna end here. I don't know what I'm forgetting, but this is what's been happening to me, and it's completely changed my life. I have to take a lot of pills, water pills. They've told me I can only have 3 bottles, which I use all 3, and that's the maximum, 1.5 liters. And it's in the middle of summer. I can't go out, I can't do anything, because when I take these pills, that is 240 milligrams of diuretic pills, I can't even talk because of my stroke, sorry. I have to take those, and I have to use the bathroom all the time, and I cannot even drive because my eyesight is now different. I cannot see straight. One eye sees straight, the other one is like this. So they're not focusing on the same thing. I cannot walk, I have to use a walker and a cane, and they have changed my life because they don't care. And I want an attorney who can, on my behalf, stand up for me and people like me. Thank you.